You ready?
Yep.
Hi, Jimmy. It was a good morning fishing, man. You should have been there. Check this out, man.
Oh yeah.
Number two.
Damn, that's a big one.
Yeah. Number three.
There she goes, back to the big blue. Holy shit, look at that motherfucker.
I got a fifth one, but I had to let him go because he looked like he was going to die.
Damn, he's big. She's a big one. You got more in there?
Yeah, I had to let the other one go because it looked like he was going to belly up on me.
Very nice.
Woohoo! It's Wild Lake. What I'm doing is I'm taking the white 6-inch lizard and I'm looking at this lake. And as you look around, you see cliff rocks, you see, you know, gravel in certain places, tules, hardwood trees, rocks, boulders. So trying to figure out where these fish are making their beds is the key. Is you gotta look for some shelf rock, you gotta look for tules. We have all those things right in these nice coves all over the lake there. But that's what we're looking for. The water clarity is pretty visible. It's got a real good growth on the bottom, so it makes seeing down in a lot of places a little difficult. It looks like there might be an algae bloom starting to happen or something, but the water's pretty dingy. We're expecting it to be gin clear, like 20 feet deep, but that's not the case, so we're really having to pay attention and look for these fish. I'm typically finding the beds and then letting that white lizard just dead stick it there until I see some movement, or pop it a couple times and watch for a flash, because you really can't see those fish like you normally would because this water is typically gin clear. I mean, you can see down usually like 15-20 feet easy, but today you can only really see down about 3 or 4 feet, and most of these bass are bedding in 4 to 10 or 15 feet of water, so it's real hard to see the bigger ones. But anyway, coming at you live in 3D from Saguaro Lake, Arizona, Lair of the Lizard. It's time to get your arm broke. Good.